What's up guys, my name is Senaid and in today's tutorial I will talk about the importance of testing your code and why you should never believe the tutorials that you find anywhere on the internet. In one of my previous tutorials I have been talking how you can create forgot password system in PHP with MySQL. So at the end of that tutorial I have made one mistake that is actually a huge security mistake. So now you can ask why will I do that if I know that is the mistake. So the reason is that I wanted to really see how many people listen what am I talking about, and when I say that you really have to test every code 100 times if it's need, just to be sure that everything is secure and is working 100%. So in that tutorial I have made the code that is working just perfect, everything is looking good, and you maybe won't think that there is any problem and you can just save it, upload to your web hosting and that's it. But basically that is a huge security mistake. So when I upload that tutorial I think it like I will wait until I see that someone asks why would I made that mistake, and then I will record this video to explain why I did that. But a few days later in my Facebook private group I was truly surprised when I saw that someone asked about that security mistake, because to be honest I didn't expect that in the next few months. So here's that question. Once I saw that question from Adam, I was really happy and surprised, and because the goal with my YouTube channel is not only to teach you how to code, I want to teach you how to think on the different way, to think outside of the box and really apply the knowledge that you have. So in this video tutorial I want to show you how to fix that problem and improve the security in that forgot password system, but also I want to show you that even if you maybe know me and even if you trust me, you should not do that, because maybe you will sometimes find someone who just tried to code but he doesn't 100% understand the code, and maybe later in your career you will use that code just as is, and that approach will really make you a lot of trouble. So please, anytime when you find any tutorial, any information, do anything, do some additional research, do some additional tests, and be sure that you're 100% sure in your knowledge. So let me now show you on my PC what am I talking about and how we are going to fix that issue. So now I'm here at my PC and going to show you what is the security issue that I have been talking about. So first thing that we are going to do is we are going to request new password. So request password. Okay, and now if we check our database we can see that the token has been generated for my username. So if I use this token and try to reset new password, hit enter, as you can see I've got new password, and in the database if we check now password has been updated and the token is blank. But what if I try to just remove this token and hit enter, as you can see the password has been changed again, and now I can basically 100 times change the password. So that is not the problem, but you have to understand if new user registered to your membership website and if some attacker know his email, he can always reset his password and basically gain access to his account. So imagine that now you know some of your friends' email account of the Facebook. So now you will be able just to use and reset his password and use his account, and that is huge security mistake. So now I'm going to show you how you can easy protect that. So now here we have the reset password code, and here in this query we can easy just say that
Not only that, email needs to be equal email and token equal token. We also need to specify that token has to be different than empty string. So now if someone try to reset his password, you'll get please check your link. And basically with that simple statement, we have added more layers to our security of this forgot password system. But not only that, I'm going to show you one more thing how you can protect too. So what if someone hit here request password and just he doesn't check his email, he just try the password and he have the correct. So basically he will never open that mail that he got from us. And what if someone just click that link anytime in the future and he will be able to gain access? So the thing here is that we are going to add some expiration date to this token when it won't be available anymore. So the first thing that we need to do is to go to the users table, and after that to go to the structure and here add one more column, which is go, and here I will say it expire. Okay, and here we will say date time. Okay, and hit save. Now if we check, we have added new column to this table. Now if we open our forgotpassword.php, this is the place where we request new token and URL where user will be able to request new password. Here we want to set the expire date for this token. So what we need to do is we will set like this. Here expire equal date add, and now we need to put two parameters. First parameter is from which date, which we want to use now, and the second parameter is for how long it will be. So I will say interval 5 minutes. Okay, and now we can go and test this string. Okay, or we can do it like this. Okay, request password. And now if we check our database, you can see now this expire date has been changed. And since, as you can see, at my clock it's 1 p.m. right now, and expire is set to 1 p.m. and 5 minutes. So after the 5 minutes, no one will be able to use this token again and reset this password. But in order to achieve that, we need to make one more change in the resetpassword.php. So since we have this clause here, we also need to add and expire bigger than now, which means that the time that we have in the database is bigger than right now. Because if now is 1 p.m. and 10 minutes and the date in the database is 1 p.m. and 5 minutes, it means that user won't be able to change the password. So now we can test that too. We will use the token. Okay. And now if we put this token here and hit enter, as you can see, it's resetted. Okay. But what if we do this? We will request again. Okay. Set it 5 more minutes. Okay. And now, what if I say that the expire is at 12? Okay, so which means that if our code works properly, we won't be able now to reset. Hit enter, and as you can see, it says, please check your link. And basically, that is another layer of the security. So now we have protected our forgot password system from SQL injection. We have added expiration date to token, and we have set the token that can be empty, which is good protection. So now I have one question for you. What else can I do to improve the security of this forgot password system? If you know the answer, please comment below. Also, please like this video, share it, and please join our Facebook group. Take care.